Good morning, students. In class 11th, now we are going to start with the topic Measures of Central Tendency. Let me tell you the same topic you have done in your 10th class also. So, we are just revising the same topic for you. We have chosen to be taught this topic. Why? Because already you are in touch with the same concepts and then it will be easy for you to cope up with the syllabus. And so today we are going to start with measures of central tendency. Measures of central tendency are those measures which gives us the central value of the series or which gives us the average of a particular series. Now, why it is important to get the central value or the average of any series? For example, as your economics teacher, I want to know your marks of SST, right, in 10th class pre-board. So, if you are 30 in one class, then all of you will tell me your marks. And then it will not be easy for me to remember the marks of each and every student. Then what I will do, I can take an average. For example, if the average of your marks, I have find it out as 70. So that 70 will tell me that this class is above average class. And if the average comes as 35 or 40, so the same indicate that this class is below average or weak class. So that is why some facts are easy to remember when we find out the average value or the central value of the same. Now, to find out central value of a particular series, we have three more measures, that is mean, median and mode. Mean, median and mode. First of all, we are going to start with arithmetic mean. When we are talking about mean, we are having three types of mean, that is arithmetic mean, geometric mean and harmonic mean. But in our syllabus, we are having only arithmetic mean. So let's see the definition for arithmetic mean. Arithmetic mean is defined as sum of values of a group, right? First of all, what we have to see? We have to see the total of the values of a group. And then divided by the number of items, right? For example, if 30 students are there in one class and all are telling me their marks in SST, first of all, I will take the total of marks of 30 students. Then after taking the total of 30 students, right, then what I will do, I will divide the sum of marks with the number of students. So mean is a mathematical average. This question can be asked to you in one mark, right? When we are talking about mean is a mathematical average. Mathematical average means we have to calculate arithmetic mean in order to get the average out of it. So today we'll be solving two formulas, right? The very first is, we are solving the numericals of individual series. Now let's understand what is individual series. Individual series, you can see one statement. In the same statement, only marks are given. Marks of the class is 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Frequency is not given, only marks are given. So this series will be known as individual series. So, individual series, and we are going to apply first direct method, right? X bar mean is denoted by, symbolically mean is denoted by X bar. So, X bar means mean, then the direct method is equal to, X bar is equal to sigma X over N. What is sigma X? X means, this means the total of X. Take the total of X first and then N means number of observations. Number of observations 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. So first of all we have to take the total of all the marks, that is 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 40 plus 50, and the total has come as 150. And how many are number of observations? Number of observations are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is equal to 5. So by dividing 150 by 5, we are getting the average marks of the students and that is equal to 30. This is a very simple method. Take the total of all observations and then divide it by number of observations. Now, if we want to apply, we can apply shortcut method also. Now, in shortcut method, what we people are doing, the formula is equal to A. This A means assumed mean. Assumed mean means any value from the given series, we can assume as assumed mean. It is not necessary to take the mid value always. You can take 50 also as assumed mean. You can take 40 also as assumed mean. I have assumed 10. After taking assumed mean, we are going to find out dx. Dx means deviation of x, difference between x and assumed mean. Dx means deviations of x from assumed means. In simple ways, difference between x and assumed mean. So this is 10 I have assumed. X is also 10. 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. 20 minus 10 is equal to 10. 30 minus 10 is equal to 20. 40 minus 10 is equal to 30. And 50 minus 10 is equal to 40. So let's fill the values in this formula. Formula is A, assumed mean, plus the total of dx. Sigma dx divided by n. After taking the total, 40 plus 30, 20 plus 10, it has come as 100. Assumed mean, value of assumed mean is equal to 10, plus the total of dx is equal to 100, and number of observations, these are equal to 5. After dividing 100 by 5, it will come 20, then 20 plus 10 is equal to 30 marks. For one statement, if you apply direct method or shortcut method or step deviation method, the answer will come same. So, in the next video, we will do step deviation method. Thank you.